It's the top third cancer killer in men. Now there's word a test used to spot prostate cancer may not work as well as first thought. Channel 4 Action News anchor Sally Wiggin explains.
The study in the Journal of the National Cancer Institute looks at rising levels of PSA, the blood protein used to predict prostate cancer.
Early indicator, it's inexpensive, it's not difficult to do, but it's not terribly accurate.
Dr. Ralph Miller is a urologist at Allegheny General Hospital. He sees this recent study as just one more way to try to refine the accuracy of the test. This study looked at 5,500 men and found almost no difference in the rate of prostate cancer among men who have a spike in PSA levels and those who did not. In other words, rising levels of this PSA measurement are not the best indicator of prostate cancer and can lead to unnecessary biopsies, according to the study. So what is?
I think that men between the age of 50 and 75 ought to be given the option of screening, and that screening ought to consist of a PSA blood test and a digital rectal exam about once a year.
But will studies like this discourage men from getting the PSA blood test?
It doesn't seem to have much effect on what the population does. About 75% of men over 50 have now been screened at least once.
So this all begs the question, how valuable is the PSA? We'll go back 2 decades when it first began to be used to screen. Over 40,000 men died of this disease. Now that number's down by well over half, even though we have more people and an older population. Sally Wiggin, Channel 4 Action News.